Today's trip, we start at Rosendahl. And we will go with this high-end Belgium train via Antwerp to Brussels. And a quick change of trains in Antwerp. Arrived in Brussels Central, so let's go to the Royal Palace. We made it to the Royal Palace. Really good weather today. And of course, who lives here or maybe has a little guest room? King Philippe. King Philippe and his little house.
I have reached the museum of the National Bank of Belgium. The entrance is free, but please take as little stuff as possible because there are security checks. Also, the museum is only open on weekdays, so if you are in Brussels on the weekend, you are unlucky. Museum is located over two floors. Wonderful building, as you see. When I was there, I was the only visitor. They have a range of banknotes, coins that range from the beginning of the Belgian Republic, Napoleon, and also the écu. Écu, for a couple of years, was legal tender, which I did not know. Some more modern coins. Just before the euro was introduced. And of course, also the euro banknotes and euro coins. I also went for a quick stop to the Atomium in Brussels, and of course I needed to go there because the 2006 €2 coin carries the Atomium. This coin has a mintage of 5 million pieces. While in town, I also visited the LCS, LCS is the local coin shop. My choice was the coin shop of Jean-Luc, and I put the link to his shop in the video description. He has a small coin shop, but with a nice selection, and I picked a few 1,000 lira silver coins from San Marino. At the time, the bullion silver value for the coins was 9 euro, and I paid 10 euro per coin. I selected a few shiny ones from the top row. I'm not a fan of tone coins, but let me know in the comments if you liked tone coins or shiny coins. I also went to the actual National Bank of Belgium, but no photos or video was allowed inside. The National Bank there allows you to exchange coins worth 3,000 euro without any fee. I wanted to try and got what the teller called a Belgium waffle without chocolate. He gave me a shrink-wrapped package of 252 euro coins, so total value 500 euro. This is the what the teller told me, the Belgium waffle without chocolate. Quite a heavy package. It says 2.143 kilos, 500 euros of 2 euro coins. And it even says the date when it was shrink wrapped, the 5th of December 2011. And just to remind you, now is the year 2021. That means this package was in storage for 10 years. Let's open it. Let's see what we find. So I will take two rolls out of the package. And this is what the roll looks like. It's a 2 euro coin roll. And here on the packaging, you see KMR. I tried to find out what KMR stands for, but well, I couldn't find anything. Like in Belgium for everything, there are two languages, Netherlands and French. The Belgium mint in Netherlands language is KMB, the Königliche Münd von Belgien, and in French it's called MRB, Monnaie Royale de Belgique. So maybe KMR is a mixture of these two variations and these two languages. So this roll, as the date says, shrink wrap 2011, yes, surprise, surprise, the coin is minted 2011 and it's King Albert. I was hoping to get circulated rolls because Belgium didn't mint any rolls for circulation in the last 10 years between 2011 and 2021, except the 3 million for King Philippe in 2019, but that they still have this coin roll in storage since 10 years, well, I didn't expect it. Let's open the one roll. Obviously, all the coins will be the same. Here we go. So all the coins are the same. 2011, King Albert. Really shiny, obviously, because they are all uncirculated. And back to the mint. So yes, minted in 2011 by the Belgian Mint. The Belgian Mint actually stopped production in 2018. And from that moment on, after they closed, the Dutch Mint is producing all the coins for Belgium. So these coins, all shiny, all uncirculated, were the last coins minted
in the Belgian Mint. Amazing uncirculated condition, 2011, but the mintage is over 30 million. So it's definitely not a rare coin. And I will not keep these coins. I will keep one roll for my collection, but that's it.